My name is Rafa Gavenda, and I will be running today's presentation together with my colleague, Artur Kosakowski. The topic of this webinar is moving loads. You can find information about our new series of robot webinars under these links. Let me remind you about the new concept of the RSA webinars. We will focus on one or several topics in order to discuss issues frequently submitted to the support team. Begin with the general introduction of selected features of the program and develop these subjects further based on the feedback we will receive from you after each of the presentations. Please mind that these webinars are not supposed to be training sessions. The webinar will be a combination of a slide presentation and live use of robot, followed by question and answer session. As the Microsoft of attendees are muted, please submit your question using the question box of the GoToWebinar panel. In this webinar, we'll focus on creation of cases, mobile cases, moving load results, combination and automatic code combination with moving loads, tips and tricks, and frequent errors linked with moving loads. The next webinar will be for Setra application guide. Assumptions. Moving load case contains information about the vehicle as a set of loads, which moves along the road. The RBI generating number of vehicle positions along the road to apply loads on a model in each of them. It is thus possible to model cranes, trucks, road convoys, trains, trolley carriers, or other equipment, which can be substituted by the set of loads subjected to move. The moving load option is available via drop-down menu, loads, special loads, moving, or via the icon representing a small truck in the icon bar on the right-hand side of the screen on loads layout. Moving loads definition window allows to define moving load case with all the required data like vehicle itself, road factors, etc. First, define the vehicle, which is in fact the set of loads which will be moving. Click on the icon New Vehicle and then, for example, choose one of existing vehicles from the catalog, as shown here by the combo box vehicle name. The choice of the vehicle database can be made in Job Preferences, Databases under Vehicles using button with plus sign. It is also, of course, possible to define a new user vehicle as a set of loads by new button, as you can see on the slide. Name of the vehicle must be given first, then vehicle type must be selected. Let's look first at symmetrical vehicle. This is actually a vehicle consisting of pairs of loads, concentrated line or surface, on either side of an axis of the symmetry, which is the longitudinal central axis of the convoy. In most cases, this type of mobile load is used. Definition of loads is limited to the direction perpendicular to indicated view above. If horizontal or inclined components of loads should be used while moving the vehicle, they can be generated by road factors. We will talk about them later. Defining single line set of loads vehicle or on symmetry axis, in fact, can be made by specifying transverse spacing S parameter equal to 0. Loads definition is simple with one remark, as mentioned before. FQP values indicated on this slide should be defined as positive values. For example, S is the spacing of the loads, and as previously said, if S value is set to 0, there will be 2D vehicle generated. Arbitrary vehicle. In comparison to symmetrical vehicle, in this vehicle, loads can be defined in any point, not only symmetrical, and also it is possible to create horizontal loads in vehicle definition. Take a look at first picture. Fx, Fy, and Fz values can be used in the definition of the moving load. Additionally, the load factors mentioned by me before do not apply to arbitrary vehicles. For bar type structures, frame, trusses, or grilles, you can apply a load generated by a vehicle defined using concentrated and linear forces. Concentrated forces are applied as bar loads. When a concentrated force does not hit directly onto the bar, robot operates according to an algorithm that resolves the force over the neighboring bars. The linear force is modeled by 10 concentrated loads along the length of the linear load. So for the bar type structures, you cannot use a vehicle defined using planar loads. For surface structures like panels, plates, shells, you can use all types of vehicles defined using concentrated, linear, or planar loads. A concentrated force is applied as a geometrical load at point applied to a surface element, and it is resolved onto the bar element. Linear force is applied as a geometrical linear load to surface element. It is not applied to bars. Surface force is applied as a geometrical contour load to surface elements. When using this type of the load, the place where the contour load is applied is important, for it's generated on each panel located within the contour limits. To apply the load type only to selected panels, use selection option when defining the moving load case. For mixed structures, bars and shells, a linear and planar load are applied only to the surface elements. For a load originating in a vehicle to be applied directly to the bars, use concentrated forces in vehicle definition. Once convoy is defined or selected, we will go to the definition of the road. The road is the path will follow the convoy, more exactly the point x equal to 0 of the vehicle will follow the road. I will explain a little bit later. The road can be defined as a line or as a multi-segmented polyline. The road can be partially defined outside of the structure to simulate entry and or exit from the model. Number of vehicle positions is calculated considering road length and step length. The road can be defined in a space to point vehicles onto rails, even as a polyline or line not connected with the structure. For each road segment edge, for symmetrical vehicles, increasing or decreasing factors V can be applied to modify defined loads in vehicle definition while acting on the model along the road. H and L coefficients are to generate horizontal components. Keep in mind once again that these factors can be assigned to road segments only for symmetrical vehicles. Here is the example of using road parameters. On the left-hand side, symmetrical vehicle definition is displayed. On the right-hand side, red and blue arrows represent vertical loads generated due to defined road parameters. More examples and explanations can be found in Robot Help. Step field value is a distance between two consecutive vehicle positions along the road. It's recommended to set this distance as a reasonable value, not to generate too many vehicle positions, especially in the context of using them in the combinations or in combination generations. The vector entered in the load direction field gives the direction in which the loads of the symmetrical mobile load are applied. Since the load value FPQ are positive, the value 00 minus 1 is a default one corresponding to global minus z direction, gravity direction. It is suggested to leave this value, this default vector as it is, and use road segment factors to obtain correct projected forces. Take a look at the lower part of this window. Application plane is the list of the objects that are directly loaded by moving loads. As a default, it is set as automatic, and the software will therefore try to determine this list itself. There is another possibility to limit number of loaded objects by consider vehicle definition checkbox. If we specify dimensions B, like the convoy width, D1, distance between front of the convoy, and the D2, distance between the rear edge of the convoy and the rear loads, all of them can be defined under the parameters button in the vehicle definition. The software will set this information to determine the list of objects to load. However, depending on the complexity of the definition of the mobile load vehicle and the geometry of the model, we rather advise to choose the select option, giving the list of objects to load by yourself. Moving load cases are complex cases, like code combination cases or time history ones. All of them contain number of steps or components generated during calculations. In case of mobile loads, these are vehicle positions. Results for each moving load position can be accessed by the button shown on the right-hand side screenshot. Two additional envelope load cases are also generated with the same name but with plus sign for the top envelope and minus sign for the bottom envelope. Moving loads position can be displayed in a combination table, selecting moving loads display from the right hand side menu. Moving load's position can be displayed on the model using the button shown before and selecting Display of Vehicle Loads from Display menu. Let's make a small example to show you what we were talking about. So here is the robot model, kind of the bridge with two rails. And we will apply the load in the middle between these rails. So to access the moving loads, I will select loads menu, special loads, then moving, and then use already prepared the moving load. This will be symmetrical vehicle containing only concentrated pairs of three pairs of concentrated force with a distance between them two meters 75 centimeters, because in fact this is the distance between these rails. Yeah, so the distance between them is 275 centimeters, so I will specify the spacing between mobile loads, mobile forces, the same value. So once the vehicle is created or selected from the list, we can define new moving load case by specifying name, and then we need to specify create the road. So in our case, because we cannot make straight line as a road, I will create the multi-segmented polyline. So after pressing define, selecting polyline, I will connect middle of these bars as points, characteristic points for this road. So now, as you can see, polyline number 138 is created as a road. And for now, I will use these settings, default settings, as they are. So after pressing apply, moving load case is created, and then we can run a calculation to see how the program generated the loads. So what we can see, what we can display is I lost the display window somewhere. Once again, okay. Tools. Yeah, okay. So we have our display window. And what we can see, so after selecting mobile case, the first, not the envelope cases, but the main mobile case, moving load case, we can see a load generated or applied along the road by selecting. Of course, I need to display them. So after selecting loads on display window, we can activate display of vehicle, and then we can see how it moves. But of course, these are not loads which are applied directly, or may not be loads which are applied directly to the rails or to the objects. So to check whether loads are applied correctly, we can see applied loads by displaying forces generated automatically. And In some cases, you may see the loads are also applied to different members than should be it's supposed to be applied. So in such case, we can limit the number of objects to be loaded in two ways. So let's go back to loads type definition window, and then after making double click on the moving load, we can edit it. So once again, I will not change anything in the vehicle definition, and also I want to update existing load case. So first thing, what we can do is we can limit the selection of the objects which should be loaded by activating selection and activation plane. So in our case, I will select only the rails. So now, as you can see, they are highlighted into red. Copy the selection to this window. Once again, and then press apply to update the definition of moving load case, and let's generate forces again. Okay. As you may see now, it's much better, but not perfect. And you can see these triangles as generated forces. So we want to apply the moving loads as the point loads directly onto the beams. So in such case, I will edit once again the moving load case, and in the parameters of the moving load case, I will specify tolerance. Just the tolerance is the distance from which, or the range of the applying of loads, and from this range, if the load is within the range from the road or from the member, the load is directly loaded. So let's say in our case I will specify 10 centimeters, just to be sure that only rails will be loaded as a point loads. Okay, and press apply. Point one, okay. So once again, updating case number 4 and generating loads. So now, as you may see, all loads are generated as I expected, as only as a point loads. Okay. So this is one way of correcting the loads. What we can do also is we can define this vertical components, horizontal components, by defining parameters. So I will select once again moving load case, and under parameters I will just specify the load factors, of course not real ones, but just only to show you how it works. So I will generate horizontal forces on segment 2, H2, and segment 3. Okay, and press apply, and then you can see I will move our vehicle back, and as you may see now, the vertical components are generated on the third edge and the second edge. So this way you can define some friction force, horizontal force, or braking force using symmetrical vehicle. Let's look at the first point. Okay, so there is another parameter which can be sent here. So if we want to consider vehicle position at the beginning and the end. We can activate these two checkboxes and then generate loads again. So let's look, where is my load? Oh, by mistake, I generated new mobile case. So as you may see, it starts because of this definition, the whole vehicle starts on the structure and stops when it's still all on the structure. All loads are located on the structure. So this depends on the two parameters. Either whole loads, whole vehicle can be started directly on the model, or just only each pair or each separate load, depending on the model geometry and vehicle definition, can be enter and can exit the model. So as mentioned during the presentation, all time steps of the moving loads are displayed in in combination table. So because I don't have any combination yet in this model, as a default, all the moving loads positions are listed. If the combinations are displayed or count combinations are displayed, we can click right hand mouse button on the table, then select table columns, and then switch display of this table to the moving loads components display. Okay, let's go back to the presentation. Regarding the code combinations, when a moving load case is present in a model, each convoy position will be combined with other load cases of the model. This can be done either in automatic combinations way, see display of the code combination definition in this table's screenshot. The number of two means this is the load, mobile load case number. And on the right-hand side, you can see the slash, and after that, the case component number, which is a vehicle position. Or you can create combination manually. And mobile loads can be used in manual combinations, but after calculations, the results can be viewed under newly created combination numbers in the same manner as for simple moving load case. As you can see on these pictures, combination number 6 is created, but after running calculation, the results for this combination are available under new numbers 19, 20, and 21. In case of nonlinear model or running nonlinear calculations of already created manual combinations with moving loads, combinations have to be created in a different way. All previously created such combinations should be automatically set as auxiliary by the program. The moving load positions or position should be converted onto simple load case or simple load cases and used in manual combination definition. Components can be converted onto simple load cases from the combination table while displaying moving loads, or from case component window by the create a case from the component button. Then some load case can be used in the combination definition. Such load cases can be also used in semi-automatic load combinations by selecting manual combination on the code combination window, and then after selecting one or more combinations suggested by the program, we can press generate button to see them on the list. So let's get back to our model and make some combinations. So for simplicity, I will delete the case number 8 and then calculate the model. So how to generate the combinations? Automatic way. Loads automatic combinations, then we can select full combinations, then after pressing more, I will disable these three types for simplicity on our show. Then on cases we can see that our moving load case is selected for call combination generation. Here we can check the groups and the relations. So I will move dead load cases to the right hand side and also move our moving load to the right hand side and then press generate. Of course, as you know, this is not the way the program automatically generates the code combination, so in fact we need to, after pressing this generate button, we need to calculate the whole structure. And let's look at the combination table now. So in the combination table, now you can see all ULS combinations generated. So let's say first three load cases, 1 to 3, are simple load cases. Case number 4 is moving load case, and after this, the component or load position, vehicle position, is displayed and combined. So this way, program automatically generates code combinations. Let's do it in manual way for linear model, let's say. So for simplicity, I will disable code combinations, and then now we can create manual combination. So we can select all these cases, so just only one moving load case will be selected for combinations. And as you may see now, the combination number, newly created combination number, is 12, manual combinations number. So after calculations, as mentioned before, the results will be presented under different numbers, but with the same name of the combination, because in fact program needs to generate additional combinations and present them in the same way as for code combinations or moving loads. That's why you may observe small discrepancy between defined number of combination number and presented results combination. So as you may see, let's select combination number 8, and then here we can see the definition of the combination with all the loads. So as you can see, there is no more for the result presenting combination number 12. And in the same way, we can look at the definition of this combination. So in fact, okay, let's do it this way. So this combination, generated combination, is displayed as a kind of automatic combination. Okay, let's look how to handle the combinations for nonlinear model, or if we want to calculate combinations in nonlinear way. In such case, we need to extract, we need to convert positions we want to consider in combinations onto simple load cases. So either we can do it by selecting moving load case and using this button. So let's assume I will convert this position, create case for yes. And now, as you can see, the moving load case is created, and also you can see generated loads in the load table. So you can see this load generated. And in the same manner, we can create a simple load case from moving load case from table. So for example, this one, this position, or maybe not position number one, position number four, let's say. Moving load case component here is, you can find this option. And it should be generated. No, not yet. Once again. Okay. And then, okay, by mistake I made component one, position one, as a simple load case. And then this cases can be used in combination definition, for example, moving load with self weight, okay. And then we can easily change them for any nonlinear calculations we want to perform, because in fact this moving load cases contains real forces applied on the structure. So how to create the semi-automatic combinations for nonlinear model or for nonlinear calculation from loads many. Let's go to the automatic combination table window, and then we should select manual combinations, then more, okay. So just for simplicity, I will disable these three types. Let's say deactivate these two cases. Okay, and then I'll update relations, and after pressing next, program generates the combinations in behalf of us, and then we can select the combinations from the positions we want, and then create manual combinations. Let's go back to to our presentation. The results obtained for the moving load case can be presented in two ways. The first method, consisting in display the result of the static case for a moving load position, once selected, one can also move the load step by step or take advantage of the animation of the vehicle and the results for the moving load. The second method consists in the displaying the changes of the value of the selected quantity in the selected point because of the movement of the load over the structure, that is the display of the influence lines for the selected quantity. It can be accessed via results menu advanced influence lines. Influence lines can be presented also for finite elements. So let's go back to robot. I will load different model. So we have the shell bridge with some bar parts, and as you can see here we can have vehicle defined mobile load. So let's look how it works. Moving loads vehicle. So this is the two sets of parts of loads, and we can see them moving like that, and also it's possible to display results in a standard way as for static, the same manner for the combination. So we can select combination with the mobile load, and then we can see also the presentation of results in the same manner. Okay, so let's look at the MXX map. So we can display MXX, and then we can look at the position one by one, or we can also run the animation and see animated results if we want. So we can see results while the vehicle. Of course, the same type of, or the same manner of presenting results can be done for bars or for nodes. So we can display the results for all of them. But let's look now at results directly linked to the mobile cases, moving loads, typical results, which are called influence lines. So I will open the influence lines window from the results menu, and then select the quantity I want to display. So let's say I want to check the FZ reaction in node number 5. So I will look at the nodes results, then let's say FZ direction, FZ reaction for all steps in our case, and I will select node number 5. So after pressing apply, program generates influence lines for this node from the moving load case or from the combination containing moving load case. The same if we want to make display of results for finite element. So let's say we want to look at the results of this element. So we can see also influence lines for finite elements. Let's go back to a presentation. There is another option in robot for generation kind of the moving load results, influence surfaces for plate and shell structures, but not these results are not really linked with the moving load cases we were talking about. The influence surface is a diagram of the relationship between a certain results quantity, such as force or displacement at a given point, and the position of the unit force on the load surface. A value of the influence surface at any point on any surface is a value of selected results quantity if the unit force is positioned at this point. As you can see, program generates colorful maps basing on which one can load the model to obtain extreme results in a given point for given quantity. So let's look at a small example. I will load another model. So we have free span, let's say bridge or free span slab, and we want to look at the results for the load patterning. As you may see, there is no moving load case defined, so we don't need it. So, moving load pattern, load pattern option can be accessed from loads menu. And let's look how to define it. So I will consider checking position of this unit force on all of these three spans. So I will select all these three panels and then add the quantity I want to look at. So let's say I want to use, I want to look at the MY reaction in the node, let's say this one, 38. After pressing apply and close, then I will generate the results. Okay, and here we can see the results. So program generates kind of the influence surfaces depending on the let's say color. Here we can see how to load the model to obtain extreme values of a given quantity in a given point. So for example, to obtain maximum positive moment as a MY reaction in node 38, we should define the load on this panel, which is indicated in red color. This window also allow us to create such load case, but of course it's not made automatically. So we can create the load case itself. So as you can see, the load case is generated, but it's empty load case. And either from this window, we can define the load, let's say -5 as example, and then we have to specify the contour, for example, like that. Or, okay. Or we can use standard load definition window just to apply this load. And then after calculations, we should get maximum extreme values of the quantity we selected on the model. Some tips and tricks and common mistakes which you can encounter using moving load in robot. While defining vehicle, switching between tabs may lead to losing already entered data. To prevent this, against this, please press Add button to keep changes on the tabs. Where to find the vehicle definition for report? The display of vehicle and all list of forces defined inside the vehicle definition can be found in the calculation node available from the analysis menu. If the combinations with moving loads are not generated, you should check first the maximum number of generated combinations set in job preferences. As a default, the limit is set at 64,000. Of combinations. In case of large number of vehicle position, this limit can be exceeded and combinations will be not generated without any warning. So if you encounter similar problem, start from increasing this value in job preferences to see whether the combinations are not generated because of this limit or due to another reason. It may happen that apply button is not active on influence lines window. Influence lines results are available only for moving load cases. So select moving load case in cases combo box to see the apply button active. It may happen that applied loads are bigger than defined or smaller than defined in the vehicle definition, and it can be easily checked as comparing sum of reactions for each positions with the load definition. In case of automatic detection of the objects to which the loads should be applied, the loads may also be applied not only to elements one is expected to be loaded. So it's recommended to apply vehicle loads on a selection of the objects. Please feel free to ask any questions concerning this subject. So we are opening question and answer session now. Fill your questions in questions panel or go to webinar window. As always, the webinar is recorded, and the recordings will be available on our YouTube channel in a few hours after finishing the webinar. And also, we will post a presentation for anyone who wants to download it. And there is a question about the moving loads and the time history calculations. No, it's not possible to use moving loads in the time history calculations, or we can do it in the way in as we discussed for manual or nonlinear combinations. So each step or single step can be converted onto simpler load cases, and then such step can be used in the time history calculations. So it's not possible to use the whole moving load case in time history calculations, but only converted moving load step.
In addition to Rafael's explanation, maybe some additional tips. If you want to consider dynamic effect of the moving load, then the example was presented during our previous webinars for time history analysis. So I strongly recommend to watch the recording of this webinar. You can find the explanation and the example of such analysis.
There is a question about different countries' standard vehicles for moving load databases to prepare or to ship by Autodesk. So for now, my answer is that due to Autodesk policy, we cannot talk about what will be in the next release or releases of the software. But as mentioned during the presentation, one can easily create the database and also the vehicles for usage. So let's look at databases, vehicle loads. So to create the database, whole database, of course, at this stage it will be empty database. We can press this button, then name it as we like, set the default units. Okay, so this is the empty database, and then while creating moving loads, wait a moment, loads special loads, moving loads, we can create the moving load vehicle directly into the database. So after selecting the database, we can create new and then I haven't saved it, new, and then save it to so the database, so it can be easily defined and saved into the database. As there is no other questions in our panel and we are running out of the time, I would like to encourage you to use these links to learn more about robot and different solutions for your problem on using our webinar discussion forum and also some articles on AKN. I would like to thank you for attending this webinar and invite you to join the next webinar on the topic Setter Application Guide, which will be on 5th of October 2016 year. Thank you for attending this presentation.